Hey, what's up, what's up with Monkey Grip over here? One Coach's Opinion, night version. How are y'all doing tonight? Remember, it's my opinion, it's not a fact. Nah, One Coach's Opinion, just something to cross about. I'm calling this a coach's burden. Because look, I want to explain what we go through as coaches, trying to work with people all day long. As a coach, I sit there and try to find people's mistakes, and that's what majority of coaches do. Correct mistakes all day long, all day long. So here's where it gets tricky, and here's why I say it, a coach's burden. Sometimes, well, all the time, it's going to be a coach's job to figure out what went wrong, or even on times when I tell you something went right. We have the job of spoiling the fun, I guess you want to say. So, say you got a kid 11 years old. He wins a fight. You see a lot of mistakes he make winning his fight. And you, okay, when you get back to the gym, we're going to talk about these mistakes you made. You know, let him have his win in. We're going to talk about the mistakes you made. And maybe I've had a problem in the past of not letting you get past the let's see, the mistakes you made, Pop. That same night. So I didn't wait to the gym. I might want to say it right there. And I mean, most likely my advice would be wait to the gym the next time, jot down some stuff, and help them understand that that's still my job to go through this victory and see if you made any mistakes. We can't ignore the mistakes. We can't let a win take away the fact you made mistakes. You just got away with making mistakes. And you might not get away with the same mistakes with a more experienced fighter. That's what a coach knows. That there's levels to this, and at one point in time, you're gonna find somebody that might not let you get away with this bull, or whatever you're doing, or holding your hand down, or that's one of my things all day long in the gym. I'm pick your hand up, pick your hand up. Somewhere along the lines, people show people how to fight with their left hand down, and excused it. And I probably was a coach like that too in the past. And now I'm more like, man, fight, put your hand up. Them hands are valuable for defense. But, so, take this same 11, 12-year-old, say maybe 10-year-old, put any age you want. He wins a fight. Hooray, 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 everybody. Hey, oh my God, did you see what he just did? I'm on a little Tino one, the Golden Glove. What, I can't believe it. Yeah, man, he's 8-year-old champion. And I understand this to a father, a family, to cousins. Hey, man, he just won the Golden Gloves. He's 8-year-old champ. To a coach that's been there, that's kind of like, I mean, we don't want to knock his burden. And we're not going to say nothing. We're going to be like, congratulations. But I've had people be like, I mean, it seems like he's more exciting than this. Your son's 8 or 9 years old. We have a long way to go. Boxing never stops. You know what I'm saying? It goes on all year round. So, forgive me if I'm not super excited, but I will congratulate him. We getting the high fives. I mean, I'm not going to let him know, hey, yeah, I ain't really like what was going on. But, I mean, I ain't like that. You know, yeah, I'm okay, good. Congratulations, man. Hey, well, man, I'm taking my picture. Hey, congratulations to him. Encouraging him to keep coming to the gym. We move on. But then we get to the gym. I might have to say, you know what? You won that, but you did this. You did this. Now, what I'm battling against is the 100 people that patted him on his back and told him how good he looked. You know, against me telling him, trying to correct the mistake. And some kids get it, and some kids are like, coach is an asshole. You know what I'm saying? In their minds, hopefully they don't, you're not saying that to your coach. Man, I beat that kid, and then the coach didn't even, you know, blah, blah, blah. I mean, yeah, but you might have beat a kid that you were supposed to beat or you had a good chance to be because of your experience, but you still might have made mistakes that we still got to grow from. Okay. Prime example again. A kid loses a fight. Same 8 or 9 year old kid, right? Loses a fight. Now I have to have the burden of being the guy that says, after the loss, being the guy that has to correct mistakes. But guess what? You got a grandmother, grandfather, father, mother, sister, brother, blah, 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 telling him, you did good. You did good. You'll get him next time. You did good. You did good. Now, I'm not trying to say trash him, but I'm just saying, y'all gotta realize with all these people, you did good, or try again next time, blah, 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 and not even trying to correct them. You know what I'm saying? It's just hard for a coach. And it's kind of like, damn, I mean, if he wins, you don't want us to parade him. If he loses, you don't want to pep him up. I'm not saying either one. I'm just saying it becomes our burden because we're the only people that are trying to tell him what's right and wrong. And pretty soon, it becomes a coach's burden. And it's like your coach never satisfied. A good coach ain't never going to be satisfied. You got coaches, Barry Hunters, you got your Bo Max, you got your Ronnie Shields, you got your Freddie Roaches, you got your Derrick James, you got all these guys. I mean, don't you think Derrick James is still correcting Earl and teaching Errol Spence? Errol could say, man, I beat everybody. I need one more belt to get at 147. I went out and beat everybody. But they're still learning, and Derrick James is still correcting him for making mistakes. I don't care. You can pick out your best fight ever, show it to any coach you want, and say, you think I made any mistakes here? And if you really want him deciphered, he might be like, yeah, you made some mistakes. I mean, you got passed. That's the important thing. You know what I'm saying? If that's what you look out, but a real coach will say, yeah, we need to correct this and correct this because the next time you fight somebody or fight somebody like him, they might take advantage of such things. It could be somebody could expose your weakness in the 12th round and a guy didn't have enough time to finish you off and your weakness got exposed. There's so many things that could go on, but as coaches, it's like our burden to bust the bubble. While everybody else is patting you on the back and everybody else is listening to what you're saying, everybody else is listening to your excuses, everybody else is listening to what went on here, it's kind of like the coach that, and then like, you know, it's the coach that got to say, I was about to talk about something, I'll cut my own self off. It's the coach that has to say, this, you did this, or you did this. And then not only the people that really are just being supportive, now we got the haters that really just don't like to see y'all doing well, because trust me, you're going to find those. And you got to find some people that they're not exactly haters. They just didn't get involved. Like, for instance, I had a kid came in the gym, couldn't throw no punches, couldn't throw nothing. He still hasn't had a fight. But the kid actually has a lot of potential. He's defensively minded. He's well-running. He loves to come to the gym. He has a lot of potential, you know? So I had to ask him. I said, let me ask you something. Because I see him doing a bunch of different stuff, seeing a bunch of different stuff. I'm like, Joe, where are you getting this stuff from? Are you watching YouTube and just creating it? Or you got somebody, man, my uncle and my two uncles help, man, and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, well, you know what I mean? It's hard to coach when I don't recognize the stuff that you're doing. You know, when it don't go with our program. I'm not saying they don't know what they're talking about. I'm saying even if they do know what they're talking about, Their program has to match our program. It has to come in. It has to all get together for you to gel. You know, if you say to your coach, "Man, coach, I need to go to the body more," then y'all got to initiate a plan which opens up your body shots. I mean, opens up your body shots so you can go to body more. You just can't have nobody jump in there and say, "Yeah, body, body, body." It's a smart way to get to the body based on how you're fighting. You know, but my main thing, and I asked him, I said, "Let me ask you something. Before I trained you and before you started looking good shadow boxed, and before you, how many people came up to you and said, 'Man, I should teach you how to box'? How many people thought boxing was going to be for you?" And this probably is with any sport. Think about it. Before you really got good, how much advice were you getting? Because even when I used to coach football, and any parent that remembers me coaching football would say, I like to work with, I didn't mind not being one of those coaches that stood around the other four coaches that watched the main kids run the offense. I kind of like being that guy that was helping the kids that couldn't play that well. And I would tell them, "Man, let me just work with these guys. They're on the sidelines doing nothing anyway. Let me teach them how to stand. If we can build them up and they can be helpful for the team, even if they could give guys a few breaks and give us rest breaks." That's what some people, that might be your role as a team. You could be a third down back. You could be, everybody's not going to be the starting person. But let me work with the, if you want, I'll go work with the field goal kicker. But I see no reason for five guys to stand around and watch a guy run his offense on probably half a defense at a certain level when we talk about kids. Because, you know, kids going to play both sides. And everybody's standing around. I was always that coach that wanted to look at weaknesses and make them better. And anybody know me coaching knows I always coached a little bit outside the box and thought about what's going on and found a way to accomplish something or try to accomplish something. But coaches have the burden of being the ones that have to correct everything. And we had an example today of, like I said, if you got a test score, you had 100 questions. Do you want the person to just mark what's wrong? So say you got 96 of them right. Do you want the person to mark the wrong ones, or do you need to see 96 C's and 4 X's? Some people actually need to see the 96 C's. And I'm laughing because I'm sitting across the street finishing this up and looking at a liquor store on the drive-thru, and it's actually a guy standing in the drive-thru with his dog, like, like, my turn next. And his car's behind him and everything. But anyway, so, yeah, so we have that burden, man, that no matter what, we got to be the spoil sport, if that's what you want to call it. So all day long, it just seems like we're picking on you. No, we're correcting problems, hopefully. But if you have a coach that you feel that, you know, no matter what I do, you get on me, you're picking on me, I'm not getting any better or nothing like that. If you got a coach that yells at you and you're 2-20 and every day you're getting yelled at, I mean, it might be y'all system ain't working that good. That could be something too. But the proof is always going to be in the pudding. Like I tell people, I said, coaching is like Kool-Aid. I mean, we all pretty much use the same stuff. We all have a ring usually, or access to a ring. Most of us have bags, the same type of bags. Some people go get specialty bags that might make a guy a little bit special. But we all have mitts, paddles, whatever you want to do to make them good. It's like Kool-Aid, but everybody's Kool-Aid don't taste the same. And I break it down because Kool-Aid is just powder and sugar. Some people want to use 2 packs. Some people use 1.5 packs. Some people use too much sugar. Some people use too much. But bottom line, we all have the same ingredients. And the proof is in the pudding. But our whole job all day long is to correct mistakes. And sometimes people look at us like, "Geez, man, you ain't never satisfied." No, probably won't be. And if you do run into that satisfied coach that said, "We ain't got to work on nothing, man, you've reached the top," I don't know what to tell you. One coach's opinion, tell me what y'all think.